Greetings, loyal subscribers and honoured guests. I finally had the opportunity to try the PS5 over the last week, so I am launching PS5 Hive, a new playlist where I can gather up all of my thoughts about Sony's latest console. These episodes will be sporadic and mixed up with all the other series I've got going on, so don't expect one every week. What better place to begin with than the game that comes pre-installed on every PS5 console, Astro's Playroom. This isn't the first outing for Astro, with him having starred in exclusively PSVR releases until now, but it is the first game that I have played featuring him. He's a pint-sized robot that oozes charm and personality, and gives the like of Mario a run for his money in multiple ways. I never thought that I would see a game so bursting with innovation and fun new gimmicks outside of a Nintendo console, and yet Astro's Playroom easily rivals the likes of Super Mario Galaxy and Odyssey with the variety and quality of the task it will ask you to complete. Everything is centred around the brand new DualSense controller and showing it off all of its new functions in the most fun and intuitive way possible. Upon starting the game, it will run through various elements such as the haptic feedback that is so precise you can feel each individual raindrop fall upon your metallic body, or the new triggers that can change the amount of resistance you feel to match any given situation. These combined with older aspects such as the touchpad and the built-in speaker that make a return from the PS4 pad all combine to make you feel fully immersed and engaged with the game. Anyone who has been playing video games for as long as I have can be forgiven for feeling a little jaded sometimes, and that we've seen it all before, but every so often a game like this one comes along and reignites our excitement for the medium. I had a massive grin on my face all the way through playing Astro's Playroom, and had to literally force myself to stop playing and do something else on the first day, or I would have finished the whole thing in one sitting. As it stands, it's taken me roughly 4 hours to journey through each of the four areas in the game, but I have missed quite a few collectibles and there's still plenty of artifacts I need to find. These take the form of various PlayStation consoles or accessories that have been released throughout the years, each lovingly recreated in digital form and gathered up in the PlayStation Labo area of the game. I sometimes still mistakenly find myself thinking of Sony as a newcomer to video games, but seeing all of their legacy gathered up around like this, combined with the many little Easter eggs scattered all the way throughout the experience, brings into sharp focus just how much of a part of the fabric of gaming they've become, just as much as Nintendo has. You will find other little bots dressed up as a Sly Simeon from Ape Escape, or Kratos and Atreus from the most recent God of War, as well as encountering the Robot from Jumping Flash, or a scene from Vib Ribbon playing out in some hidden room. In terms of presentation, Astro's Playroom has a deceptively simple and clean look to it, reflecting the metallic nature of the robotic protagonist. It may not have the same sort of wow factor as something like Spider-Man Miles Morales, but look a bit closer and there is a lot going on, with not a single dip in performance. The levels are bright and vibrant for the most part, with the occasional moody area, such as the stage set amongst the thundery clouds, which showcases the lighting to good effect. Backing up the visuals is a fantastic soundtrack and some of the best surround sound that I've heard in a game in quite some time. You will feel enveloped by the sound of the game, both from your regular speakers and from the small speaker in the controller. Combined with the tactile controls, it's yet another way the game makes you truly feel immersed in the experience. Somewhere within each group of four levels that make up one of the regions of the PS5 you are running around in, you'll find a unique gimmick, such as rolling around in a ball using the touchpad, or squeezing the adaptive triggers to coil up your springy legs. These took a little bit of time to adjust to, but it wasn't long before I got the hang of them. Astro's Playroom isn't a difficult game by any means. You have infinite lives, it's much more about having fun and getting to experience it all. Now we come to my one gripe about the game. I wish there was more. The game is so much fun and so well done that poor Astro really deserves to start in a full-length experience. I really hope that Asobi Studio do actually get to make a full retail product in the future, as I would gladly pay for a lot more content like this. In the meantime, I still have those collectibles I missed to find and a series of speedrun levels that I haven't even looked at yet. It would be churlish of me to get too mad about the length of Astro's Playroom, because the game is free after all and pre-installed on each new PS5. It also never has the chance to grow stale. Definitely don't skip it, whatever you do. Make sure you play it through at least once. I know technically the game was released in 2020, but for me it will be hard to find anything else to top it as my game of 2021. There's a long way to go yet though, so something might just manage it. That brings me to the end of my very first PS5 review. I hope you enjoyed it despite the game now being roughly 3 months old. There are still plenty of people who haven't managed to get a PS5 of their own yet, so I do think an Astro's Playroom review is still relevant. If you enjoyed this, then please leave a like, drop a comment, consider subscribing and sharing the video on social media. I'll be back with another episode of PS5 Hive whenever I've managed to play something. Next week it's another installment of Cover Tape Chaos Sat, so come back for that if you're interested, and in the meantime, take care.